And you are from Tamil background or from where back, which background?
Yes, Tamil background, Maharaj.
Dandavat, Madan Mohan Prabhu. Nice to see your video.
Maharaj.
Nice to see your video.
Dandavat Pranam.
Dandavat.
You are no longer hiding behind. You are no longer hiding behind.
Hare Krishna Maharaj, Dandavat Pranam. Jai Shri Gurudev.
Jai Gurudev. So, I think you got your machine for haircut, seems to me.
Yes, Maharaj. Okay. I have to go to another one, because this one has already gone back to India, so I could find another one. Yes, Maharaj. Which was open, coincidentally. So, yes, Maharaj, I immediately rushed to the shop.
Okay. Very nice. How is Dhruva doing? He's okay?
He is fine, Maharaj. He's okay. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay. Still there is lockdown in Malaysia?
Yes, Maharaj. So there is what they call a conditional MCO. That is based on the, as per the cases and that would come, they are going to reduce or increase the restrictions and the level of controls during this. But since till December, there is going to be some or the other form of movement control order. That is for sure. So Singapore may also adopt the same model because there are more incidents of coronavirus in Singapore than in Malaysia.
Difficult, huh? When it will go, nobody knows. Huh?
Nobody knows.
Krishna has made world realize they are not in charge. They are not in charge. Krishna is in charge. Our technology is not enough to deal with such a situation. A small situation he created. Huh? And if some, pralaya comes, then what they will do? They are not aware of that. Huh? They think they are the boss. Jagai Madai were thinking they are the boss. Huh? And then Mahaprabhu calling Chakra, Chakra, then this Sudarshan is coming, then they realize who is the boss.
Then they realize. Yes, Maharaj.
Anyway, let us start our Sangha. Mukam karoti bachalam pangum langhayate giri jat kripa tamaham bande si guru dinatarinam. ओम ज्ञानतिमिरन्धस्य ज्ञानञ्जनशलाकया चक्षुरुन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः नमो विष्णुपादाय कृष्णपृष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति स्वरूपदमदर स्वामिति नामिने नमो सद्भक्तमने मणिपुरुद्भवय च प्रभुपादलस्यते वाणी प्रचार निरताय ते पूज्य श्री गुरुवर्ग वंदित महाभावान्वित सदा पूर्वापर्य परंपरा प्रचलित प्राच्य प्रमुर्तकित भक्तिर निर्मल निजरस निवृतम संरक्षकम सादरम वंदे श्री गुरुदेव नाथ शिराचार्य वर्जम निजम गुरुवाभीष्ट सुप्रकम गुरुगणैराशीष संभूषितम चिंता चिंत्य समस्त भेद निपुणम श्रीरूप पंथानुगम गोविंद विदम उज्ज्वलम भरतनम भक्तन्वितम सुंदरम वंदे विश्व गुरुम च दिव्य भगवत प्रेम्नो हि बीजप्रदम अथो नत्वा मंत्र गुरुन गुरुन भागवतार्थदान व्यासान जगद्गुरु नत्वा तत जय मुदिराये वृंदाये तुलसी देव्याये प्रियाये केशवस्य च कृष्ण भक्ति पदे देवी सत्यवत्ते नमो नमः जय श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासादि श्री गौर भक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे हरे और हम्बल दंडवत प्रणाम टू ऑल द डिवोटीज टू ऑल द वैष्णवास बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ डिवोटीज बाय द ग्रेस ऑफ वैष्णवस वी हैव सम अपॉर्चुनिटी टू हम्बली एंगेज इन द सर्विस फॉर देयर सेटिस्फेक्शन सो बिफोर वी स्टार्ट टुडेज संगा इज देयर एनी थिंग एनीबडी वांट्स टू डिस्कस
Dhanavad Maharaj.
Dhanavad.
Maharaj, I just have one little question, maybe you can say. This part of the year, the South Indian. They observe this month of Partasi.
You are a South Indian?
South Indians, yes. Here in...
On Tamil Nadu?
Yes.
I see.
My grandparents, great-grandparents come
from there. Tamil? You speak Tamil?
I don't speak. I just understand a few words, Maharaj. Okay. Unfortunately, yeah. Mm-hmm. Some of my elder brothers and sisters and family members speak. Never got into learning. So they have this thing called Partasi. And from what I can understand...
What they have?
It's a fasting month called Partasi.
Partasi?
Partasi, yes. Okay. Here in South Africa, they do this Partasi.
Okay.
It's a whole month. It usually starts 16 September mm-hmm. to like the 16th of October.
Mm-hmm.
And during that month, they don't eat any meat. They fast completely. They become like, you know, vegetarians just for that month.
Okay. You know?
Mm-hmm. So I just want to know like how to explain to them, because what I have this understanding is that during that month, they pray to Lord Govinda.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. I don't know exactly the whole pastime, how that fasting came about or anything. Hmm. But like how to try and explain to them that this fast you're
doing. Do you know why they are fasting? What is the reason? What is the objective they have in mind?
No idea, Maharaj.
Hmm.
Maybe again, it's for some purification purposes, you know, for themselves, you know.
Purification from what?
Because they're giving up eating all, you know, like meat stuff. They don't indulge in any intoxication, alcohol and things like that.
Mm-hmm.
So some of the Hindus are very strict during that month. Yes. They do like a spring clean. They clean their house. They give away all the meat stuff.
But you have to know why they are doing that. What is the objective behind that? Anybody does something, then they have some objective behind that. They do that. Some people, they follow some kind of custom. Like that story, you remember? That old lady, the mother-in-law, who used to cover the black cat with a bamboo basket. Whenever the festival is coming, she used to do that. And a newly married lady came to the house, daughter-in-law, and she was observing that the mother-in-law is doing like this. And then the mother-in-law passed away in a few days. And then what happened? The cat also died. The black cats. She was having a black cat. Then this newly married lady telling to her husband, the festival is coming. Why not you buy a black cat and a basket? And why? I have to cover the cat, black cat with a basket. So most of the Hindu tradition people, they are doing like this. Sosho Thakur told. They don't know what for they are doing those things. Just driven by some kind of family, you know, tradition and things like that. I have no idea why that has came. Actually, she was covering the black cat with the basket because the cat generally puts its mouth in the preparation that is offering for Lord prepared. The cat may put the mouth in that and it will be all damaged. That's why that lady, the mother-in-law, not wanted it to happen. She was covering the cat like that. But this newly married, you know, that lady who came, she thought, oh, this is what the festival means, you know, covering the black cat with the bamboo basket. This is what this festival is all about. So people are doing all these things without even understanding what is the origin of all those things, what is the source, and why this has been given. Certain restriction is given because that is our nature. Some Muslims, they say that if you ask them, why cannot you kill animals in the mosque? Oh, that is napak, impure thing. You cannot do that. But outside it is becoming pak. If it is something not proper inside the mosque, then it is becoming proper outside. That means Allah don't like that you kill these all entities. They don't understand it. They don't have intelligence, actually. As Mahaprabhu told, the philosophers of this Mohammedan tradition, they are not intelligent. Same way Hindus also. They're not intelligent. They have forgotten their scriptures, their teachers, their saints, everything they have forgotten. and they are following some kind of habits and customs and all those things without having any real conceptual understanding of, you know, those things. Same thing for Christians also. Christians, they go to church and to Lord, my dear Father, please forgive, take all the sins that I have accumulated in the end of the week. But why that practice is being done? That practice is done to make you free from the tendency to do further sins. Don't do that sins. That is to tell you that. Now this month that they are doing, why they are doing that, the purpose is that, that is not proper action. So try to regulate yourself and try to develop a spirit of not doing that thing throughout your life. Develop that spirit. Now slowly, gradually you are practicing, but you increase that and don't try to go towards the lower thing. That is not proper thing and not satisfying. Not to do that as a process of just for a month and then you do all nonsense. It's not. It is becoming good thing. For a month it is a crime, and after 1 month it is not a crime. Oh, this month you cannot be punished. You will be punished if you conduct murder. If you commit a sin of murder, then this month you will be punished, and other months you are free. You have license to do murder. Right? Is that the proper thing to say like that? 1 month, you are being punished. And all other months you have a license to do all the murders. Is that a law like that? It's not like that. Those who are such a sinful persons, and they are being given some opportunity to understand these things by regulating their senses. Gradually come to a higher platform. Just not, you know, be busy with some kind of, you know, negative, stopping the senses, but understand why we are doing that. What is the deeper aspect of that? There must be some connection with the satisfaction of the Lord. Must be there. In India also, some people, they don't eat all these things on the month of Kartik. In the month of Kartik, they don't do that. And then immediately the month of Kartik finish, the next day, they have a big, all this, you know, sinful feast. They do that in the, I think, Kartik Purnima or whatever. They do all these sinful activities. Such foolish persons, actually. They have no understanding. That's why Krishna says, Sarva dharman paritejya mamekam sarana. Give up all this. Christianity, Hinduism, Muslim. Give up all this religion. Come to me. Surrender unto me. I am going to tell you what is the good for your soul. Don't be so busy with your bodily identity as a born Christian or Hindu or Muslim. That's not your identity. So go beyond that. What is the religion of your soul? Jaiva Dharma. See what's your nature. Satchit Ananda, eternal consciousness and joy. How to get that? Uninterrupted. How to get that? That you have to first understand, you have to realize, then you can explain them.
Thanks for that, Maharaj. Definitely okay. Gonna use your comments when I'm speaking to them next time.
You have to also practice that. You have to practice that to free from any kind of custom. We are not just following Chi Chaitanya Saraswat Math. Custom, that is not. I have to have proper understanding of those things, why they exist. It may so happen that we are coming to an organization and just following a custom. We are not having a real realization of the teaching of those things. It is possible like that. So we have to, you know, go beyond. That's why Sripad Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj was saying, real sannyas means even renouncing that sannyas. That is real sannyas. Renouncing that sannyas is the real sannyas. Yesterday, we are having sangha with Sripad Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj. And there, in Prapanna Jivanamrita, when he was reading, and there was a subject came that when devotee advance, He even don't care what is the religious teaching in the scriptures. He don't care. How is it possible? Huh? People cannot understand it. But that is the goal. Real purpose of the goal is to go beyond the scriptures. That people don't know. That people don't know at all. Have life is by nature spontaneous, not to be restricted by anything. Spontaneous love. Raganuga bhakti. So we have to connect with Raganuga devotees to come to that platform. Without any boundaries. This mod, that mod. This conception, that conception. We have to have come to the platform of Lord's will. For Lord's will, we can even give the food dust, which is restricted in the scripture. And that's what gopis did. Anything they can do. Nobody can imagine what they can do for the satisfaction of Lord. Because they can only imagine what is there in the scripture. That what comes from the spontaneous love, they can slap Krishna. Where is that? You have to slap Krishna. In the scripture, you will not find that. So that is beyond what you can say, the guidelines given. Beyond that. One has to come to that plane. Not being bound by boundaries. This organization, that organization, this in country, that country, this color, that color. Krishna bhakti te nahi jati kuladi vichara. There is no consideration of any material identities in Krishna bhakti. Jai bhaja sei bhada. Who will do bhajan under the direction of a Vaishnava? He will be the highest. All others, jai bhaja sei bhada. Avakta hina char. Hina char means lowest, sinful. Avakta. Krishna bhakti te nahi jati kuladi vichara. No consideration of any other outward identity in the devotional life of Krishna consciousness. Any other thing anybody wants to discuss before we start the Sangha topic?
Hare Krishna Maharaj, Dandvat Pranam.
Dandvat Madan Man Prabhu.
Maharaj, maybe I can give you a small context of this question. So I saw this in one of the Vishnu Puran. There is a TV series in that. Mm-hmm. So Maharaj, in that what I saw was that once Virechan was killed by Indra. Son of Virechan is son of Prahlad Maharaj. When he was killed by Indra and then burned to ashes, so that Daitya Guru Shukracharya is unable to
make him alive.
Revive him. Yes, Maharaj. Revive him again. Mm-hmm. So it so followed that since he was burned to ashes, then later his son Bali Maharaj, he went to fight onto Indra, and then Indra killed him as well in the Indralok. Yes, Maharaj. Then Lord Vishnu appeared at that moment, and Lord Vishnu was very, very upset and disappointed with Indra. At that moment, Lord Vishnu may not be cursed him, but said that I will never, you will never be the part of my mercy. So Maharaj, that's what Lord Vishnu mentioned to Indra and other devatas, and then he left from there. Then Maharaj, how do we understand that that we see that Krishna's mercy again to Indra in the context of pastime of Giriraj Maharaj?
Yes. No, what is the absolute? Then we say that he is too infinite, then he has no limit. We say that he has no limit. But he creates his limit, and again he breaks that, and he creates another limit. Absolute means he creates his limit, and then again he violates that. like Krishna promised, I will not lift the weapon. Dandavat, Badal ji, Dr. Badal ji, namaste.
Namaste.
Namaste. Happy that you joined us.
I'm being a little late.
Yes.
I'm no sorry problem for being late.
No problem. So
yes, please go.
Yeah. So Krishna, absolute means he creates his own limit. He has no outside limit. He creates his own limit and then he again, what he can say, breaks that. Mahaprabhu told, I will not forgive you. I will not forgive you to Jagai Madai. But when he heard that, Jagai was trying to stop Nityananda Prabhu, then Mahaprabhu embraced him immediately because he's seen that some service mentality is in soul. Nobody is eternally condemned. The philosophy that is there in Christianity, that is not our conception. No, nobody is eternally condemned. There is always some scope is being given. Ye yatha mam prapadyante tam tathaiva bhajamyaham. Rupa Goswami, what he can say, told that Jiva, you get out. I given him the higher position and you want to correct him. I not like that mentality. You cannot stay with me. You get out from here. To Jiva Goswami told, when he went and, tell the correct thing to that Pandit, Ballabh Bhatta. Then Sanatana Goswami told, you are writing Jiva Daya and this is what is a Jiva Daya. Then he changed his mind. So Lord can change. If he's not, merciful to Jivas, he make them eternally condemned, then what is our position? And why is merciful? Mercy is above justice. That is our philosophy. Mercy is above justice. If we go by justice, then we all must be condemned forever. But Lord has ocean of mercy. His name is Karuna Sindhu. Ocean of mercy. Then how that justified? If he's ocean of mercy and then he condemns people eternally, then how it is justified? So justice is something lower. He was doing justice in the form of Parsuram, but then he thought, I am just killing all these Kshatriyas, but they are not learning anything by that. Then he has to teach how a Kshatriya must behave, then he has to come as Kshatriya, then that is Lord Ram, how a Kshatriya must behave. And he taught that. Then Parsuram was very much agitated when he broke that arrow, Shivadhanus, that bow of Lord Shiva. Then he told him, your job is finished. Now you go and retire. Told to Parsuram, now you go and retire. Now yours is finished. You only punished people, but you not taught how they should behave. And I am teaching. Now your job is done. Go. And he has to retire. Parsuram has to retire. Same way. Lord is not happy with the behavior of demigods and also demons. Both have some attraction for some kind of, mastership. That's where the competition is going. That is material world. But he's managing both of them. He has given power, some direction to the demons through Shukracharya and direction to the demigods through so many teachers. Narada and Bruhaspati and Brahma, so many teachers are teaching. And they have to get some power and some play has to go on. If they are, no disturbance is there, then they don't learn. Some disturbance has to be given. Otherwise, they think enjoyment is all in all. Dandavat, Umadidi, Hare Krishna. Hari Bol, Dandavat.
Hello, sorry, Maharaj. Internet connecting is problem.
Yes.
Zoom connecting from yesterday since.
Some problem is there. Everything is okay with you, Uma Didi?
Yes, Maharaj. Grace of you and Guru and Gauranga. Everything fine, Maharaj.
Jai Gurudev. So Indra wants to kill people. Kill the demons. But Lord wants to kill the demoniac mentality. Difference is there, no, Madan Mohan?
Yes, Maharaj.
He wants yes, to Maharaj. Kill the demons, but Lord shown how to kill the demoniac mentality. And we see that in Bali Maharaja. The demoniac mentality is being eliminated. That's what Lord
but
wants.
But Maharaj, a small question here. Mm-hmm. Maharaj, Virechan was a devotee of Krishna, of Lord Krishna.
No. He was a demon, actually. Brahma tested him and Indra by showing, asking their identity. Then Virechan thought his identity, this body. Yeah? He thought what he sees in mirror, that is his identity. But Indra thought, what I see in the mirror, that form is always changing. That how can I be that? Indra went some further inquiry. Those who are thinking body and bodily family and everything, Prahlad Maharaj told, they are demons. Then he had not got that teaching properly from Prahlad Maharaj. But Bali Maharaj has got, you know, some influence from Prahlad. That's why Krishna could see that. And that's why he was not so happy to have that type of dealing. Krishna can know who has what kind of wealth. Maybe at present he is behaving in a very bad way, but we don't know what kind of change will happen in his life. Krishna knows our background. We don't know. Is that okay? Clear?
Noted, Maharaj. That's a correction in my understanding. Okay, Maharaj. Now I understand. Thank you.
Okay. Any other things to ask before we go for the discussion, today's topic? All right. Today we were thinking to discuss something about material senses and mind are all trespassers and they have some inimical tendency towards our true self. So let me share with you some of the things that I have collected from the scriptures, few things about this topic. In Bhagavad Gita 3.43, it is being told, एवं बुद्धेह परम बुद्धवा समस्त भ्य तमनम आत्मन जसी शत्रुम महाभाहो खाम काम रूपम दुरासदम. Thus, knowing oneself to be transcendental to the material senses, mind and intelligence, O mighty armed Arjuna, one should steady the mind by deliberate spiritual intelligence, Krishna consciousness, and thus by spiritual strength conquer this insatiable enemy known as lust. So we have some lusty tendencies that is coming from where? The source is material senses, mind, intelligence. All can be material. So how one can, you know, steady the mind? By some deliberate spiritual intelligence, Krishna consciousness. How that comes? Spiritual intelligence. From where that spiritual intelligence comes?
From one who has spiritual intelligence, yes. He can share that knowledge.
Bali Maharaj got that intelligence from Prahlad Maharaj. Those who have spiritual wealth, by their association, one can get. Sometime it may directly come from Lord, but that is very rare. But most of the time it comes from a devotee. So we may have so many ways that desire to fulfill, we engage our senses, our mind, our intelligence in that. If you give a temptation to a person, If you do this, then you will get $10 million. And he will immediately start doing that. But you say you do it for satisfaction of the Lord, then he thinks, what is my satisfaction? How to satisfy my senses? How to satisfy my mind? How to satisfy my intellect? Very difficult thing. Because I am in the center. I means this false I. My identity is covered. I have taken my identity as body, as senses, as mind, as intelligence. And I am becoming slave of those things, those masters. Forgetting my master as Krishna. So why should I accept any master? But you already accepted the masters. Your body, your senses, your mind, your intelligence is mundane. Intelligence, mundane mind, mundane senses. You are becoming slave of that. Then devotee, he don't stop the person directly. If a train is coming with such a high speed and if you stop that train, then you will be blown away. So he gives only direction. Okay, my dear friend, you are liking this paneer. Don't take other things, this all, you know, wrong things, meat and other things. But you take paneer, you cook nice paneer, nice, you know, this preparation that is offerable to Krishna. And you offer it and you take it. What is the problem? Offer it with this tulasi leaf and you take it. You can do that. And interesting that we were reading that Mahaprabhu was narrating the story of that Mrugari, that Vyad, who was killing very cruelly these all animals, half killed. He was leaving them. Then Narad told, okay, you want to kill, then kill them completely. Don't kill them half. Don't give them pain. And then that person started thinking, oh, he should have told me, don't kill, but he telling me why kill completely but not half kill. Then he has developed some inquiry. Then Narad told, killing a person or a individual immediately, that is not so much sinful than leaving him in a suffering condition for so long before he has to die, he has to suffer so much, that is more sinful. That Narad explained. And but that's what I learned from my family tradition, that Mrigari told. But then your family tradition cannot save you from this sinful reaction, Narad Rishi says. Then he says, I was not knowing all those things. Nobody taught me all those things. Please explain me what I can do. A very nice person, huh? Already having some enough sukruti to ask like that. For Narad Rishi. Outwardly, he was doing so many wrong things, but when a saint came, he immediately changed. Immediately changed. And he wanted to follow Narad Rishi and told, okay, give up your wealth and everything what you have accumulated from all these sinful things. You distribute that and make arrangement for your bhajan in a hut. Then he was telling, oh, if I give up all these things, then how I maintain my body? How can I eat? Now I said, don't worry, I will send you food. And there is Mrugari and his wife made a hut in the bank of a river and they started staying there. So many people are bringing so much food for them. Then Mrugari was thinking, I was just asked, you know, small amount of food for my maintenance and so much is coming. Then what will happen with all these things? And next time when Narad Rishi comes with his friend, I forgot the name, maybe he's Parvat Muni. And then Vyad is saying, my dear Gurudev, I only ask little food for me and you are sending so much. Please send only that much, which is enough for both of us. We are thinking like that. How we will maintain if I not think about myself. If I not save anything for myself, and what will happen to me? If I engage everything for the satisfaction of Guru and Vaishnava, and what will happen to me? I have to save something for me. I have to have some safety, some assurance in this world. We are thinking like that. That is one of the last offense of the holy name. After hearing so much from Guru and Vaishnava, we are maintaining some attachment to material things. It is Namaprad. not the proper chanting. Proper chanting is not happening because we are not listening properly. Just coming one ear and going other ear. We are not doing practice. Sadhana is not there, means the acharan, achar is not there. That's the problem. That creates difficulties that Krishna told very nicely. So let us read another sloka, Bhagavad Gita. Another sloka in Bhagavad Gita 6.34, it is told, Chanchalam hi mana Krishna pramati balavad dridham tasyaham nigraham manne vayur eva su duskaram. The mind is restless, turbulent, obstinate and very strong, O Krishna, and to subdue it, I think, is more difficult than controlling the wind. Such a difficult thing. When Krishna says that one has to control the mind, then Arjun says, the mind is restless, turbulent, very strong, no? More difficult than controlling the wind. Wind is difficult to control. Mind is like that. Sankalpa vikalpa. The quality of mind is sankalpa and vikalpa. You know what are these things? Sankalpa and vikalpa. Anybody knows? What is the meaning of sankalpa and vikalpa? I've told many times here. Acceptance and rejection. Acceptance and rejection. That is the nature of mind. Sankalpa and vikalpa. If senses, they come across sense objects, and they cannot do anything. It is the temptation that is created by mind. Acceptance and rejection. It can go like that. Some temptation will come in you through mind. But decision cannot come from there. Decision cannot come from mind. Only temptation can come. One can see some cigarette, and he thinks, oh, I should smoke. And he says, no, I should not smoke. If you have good intelligence, then you see, why should I act foolishly? It is already written on that packet. Smoking is injurious. And why shall I smoke it? Already it is written and I am a foolish person to do that. It's going to harm me. But some bad intelligence says, no, it is very stylish. I have so many excuses. If I smoke, I will get some kind of pleasure and so many things it may tell you. So good intelligence, bad intelligence. So it is the intelligence which controls the mind. But we have no proper intelligence, then difficult to control the mind. Very difficult. Now, if we may be foolish, but if we are following somebody who is intelligent, then also very nice. We may be foolish, but somebody who is very intelligent, if we are following such a person, then it will be very nice. Uma Didi, what is happening with the Zoom is not connecting. Sorry. Uma Didi, you sent the message, it came now, huh?
Yes, Maharaj, before I sent it.
Oh, I see.
Yeah, before I send message.
I was thinking, Uma Didi is in Sangha, then why?
When I getting... start Zoom, that time I send message.
Okay. Okay. So, intelligence is very important thing that is necessary for controlling mind. Arjun was very fortunate to have his guide in the form of his guru, Lord Krishna. Is not Diksha Guru, he is Siksha Guru. Arjun is not taken mantra from Krishna. But he was very much attached. Because Krishna is understanding all these things. He knows that Krishna has all this understanding. Then he was surrendered to him. And he was very much, attached. Before he was behaving like friend. But then later on, he behaved like he is, guru. He surrendered. And Krishna also, initially he was dealing with him like friend, and gradually he increased his discipline on him. So it is something like that. The mind, if the guru or Vaishnava just remain like friend, we are like a friendly relation with Guru and Vaishnav, then we cannot control our mind. We have to allow them to discipline us. We have to have that type of relationship with them. Then they will help us. They will help us to go beyond this material, you know, plane. We have to have that type of relationship. Then such a soul is very fortunate. Otherwise, difficult. Namaste, Dr. Rajesh Tyagi ji. Can you hear us? You are mute. You have to unmute your mic. Namaste. From where you joined?
Namaste.
From which place?
Yeah, I am from Agra.
Oh, Agra. You are teaching in some institute? Are you a teacher? Or you are working?
Yeah. In Agra, I am professor.
And which department?
Extension.
Which department you are in?
Agriculture Extension.
Oh, Agriculture Department. Okay. There is a Department of Agriculture in IIT Kharagpur, where I did my PhD. That is the only IIT which has Agriculture Department. And they do a lot of the study of preserving food preservation technology. What's your expertise in agricultural science?
Research methodology.
What is that? I can't hear you.
Research methodology.
Oh, research methodology. Very nice. Have you ever done any research on origin of the seed, from where all the seeds came? The rice, dal, and then, you know.
No. That is work of agronomy.
Mm-hmm.
Agronomy department is different.
Yes. And then how many departments you need to have a complete understanding of reality?
There are 15 only departments
science,
in agriculture.
Science only knows how to have many departments, many divisions, but it does not know how to unite them all together, have a holistic understanding of reality.
Holistic approach is in Hinduism only.
Yes.
Everywhere there are many departments. They don't think.
Jasmin gyate sarva vigyatam bhavati. By knowing whom everything is known. By serving whom everything is served. That philosophy only taught in Bhagavad Gita, Bhagavatam, all these scriptures of Vedic tradition. Like you have the root in the plant, if you serve the root, whole tree is served. If you put the food in the stomach, then whole body is nourished. Same way, search the root, serve the root. That is the essence of Vedic teaching. Search the root and serve the root. That is the Vedic teaching.
Right.
That is missing in modern education. If was one question, they said, no, that is the answer that should be given by geologist. And another question to geologist, no, that should be given by biologist. And they're just, you know, running away from the understanding of the things. And they don't know finally anything. Really, they don't know. They're just like blind person touching the leg of the elephant and telling it's a pillar. And somebody is touching the belly and telling it's a wall. And somebody touching the tail and telling it's a rope. Like this, our understanding of this reductionism is like, you know, blind man trying to understand elephant. We are making a blind elephant. We are creating a blind elephant by our models. Research is based on models. Mind, we are discussing the topic of mind, and the models are product of the mind, actually. Idols of the mind. They are the idols of the mind that we have erected.
Agreed.
Our director. Agreed. Shripad Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj, he brought up a book, Idols of the Mind versus True Reality. There he discussed all these things. very nicely. We are very happy that you joined us. So thank you very much.
Thank you.
So we were discussing about how, you know, Lord Krishna, you know, behaved with Arjun and tried to help him. And we will read further about, you know, this, you know, understanding mind. As we were telling that we need a proper intelligence to control the mind. So let me share again another sloka. This is a Bhagavad Gita sloka 6.5 Bhagavad Gita. Udhared atmat manam nat manam avasadayet atmeiva hi atmano bandhur atmeiva ripur atmanah. One must deliver himself with the help of his mind and not degrade himself. The mind is the friend of the conditioned soul and his enemy as well. Here something interesting that Krishna says, one must deliver himself with the help of his mind and not degrade himself. And mind can be our friend and it can be enemy. What is the meaning? How one can deliver himself by the use of mind and not to degrade? What is the process? Anybody knows? How to use the mind to deliver oneself?
Manoj, we can say, firstly, we should offer our mind to our spiritual master. Surrender the mind.
You know that, that what Bhaktivinoda Thakur says, bhajare bhajare amar man ati bandha. You do bhajan, oh my dear mind, you do bhajan, you are very wicked. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says that. Bhaja hure mana si nanda nandana abhaya charana ravindare. So bhaja word is used. Bhaja means we have to accept the service relationship under a Vaishnava. That is bhaj. We have to give up pleasing our mind, and bhajan means please the mind of that person who has transcendental mind. That is bhajan. Try to give up the tendency to please your material mind and develop a tendency to please the transcendental mind, the person who has the transcendental mind. So Arjun wanted to please his mind, then he was facing so much trouble. He wanted to please his mind. I want to go to forest. I want to do this, and otherwise the sin will happen. This, that, so many things he was thinking to please the mind. Krishna is saying, no need. Don't follow your mind. Follow me. Guru and Vaishnava also give us discipline in that way. When Srila Govinda Maharaj come to Sri Chaitanya Sarasvat Math, then Srila Sridhar Maharaj told him, don't follow your mind, follow what I say. That is the instruction that Guru gives. Follow what I say. Can you do that? And Govinda Maharaj said, yes. And he done that. And are we doing? Are we having that type of relationship of pleasing a transcendental mind? We are busy in pleasing our material mind so much. We like it so much. We are busy with that. And thus we are suffering. That is the cause of our suffering. That material mind is our enemy actually, taking us away from our real nature. It is the business of the mind to give us new gross body. So we have to somehow learn how to kill it. We have to kill material mind. We have to kill material intelligence. We have to kill material ego. The suicide of this gross body will not help solving our problem. We have to have a total suicide. Killing material mind, kill material intelligence, kill material ego, kill material body. That consciousness completely. Material consciousness has to be eliminated by embracing spiritual consciousness. Not that, you know, just you follow the path of, you know, self elimination. That is not. The Gyan Marga or Yoga, that will not help you. You have to have a spiritual mind. Cultivate your spiritual mind. Cultivate your spiritual senses. Cultivate your spiritual body. In which form that you are going to serve Krishna. That you can only do when you come to a Vaishnava and try to please him with attachment. Otherwise, it is not going to happen. Millions of life one does listening. Millions of life, he may take initiation and do all this thing. Nothing going to happen. But when one takes discipline under a qualified Vaishnava and try to serve under that Vaishnava, who has transcendental mind, then it's possible. Very easily. Very easily it is possible. It's not difficult. So Krishna has given that explanation. So mind can be your friend. It can be enemy. The material mind is going to be your enemy. The material mind. But it can be your friend. That means you are following a transcendental mind. Then he can be your friend. Can guide you towards your real destination. So Krishna lost his mind. Sipad Bhakti Madhav Puri Maharaj says. He lost his mind. He only wants your mind. You should give your mind to him. He only wants your mind. Bhaja hure mano sinanda nandana abhaya charana arvindare. Manasa deho geho jo kichu mor arpilu tvapade nanda kishor. My mind, my intelligence, my body, my family, whatever I have, I am giving for your satisfaction. I want to engage it for your satisfaction. That we only we can learn from a transcendental mind, the person having a transcendental mind. Very nice thing that Krishna told here. Very important thing. Don't follow your material mind. It will give you a new body. Now you are in human body. It can give you dog body. It can give you plant body. The enemy. Mind is the enemy of the soul. Material mind. It can give so much conditioning. So let us read another sloka. From Bhagavad Gita 6.6. Bandhur Atma tamans tasya yenatmevatmana jitaha anatmanastu satrutve vartate ta tamaiva satruvat. For him who has conquered the mind is the best friends, and the mind is the best of the friends. But for one who has failed to do so, his mind will remain the greatest enemy. So, very interesting. For him who has conquered the mind is the best of the friends. But for one who has failed to do so, his mind will remain the greatest enemy. So, anyway, our mind is like monkey, behaving like monkey. Monkey is restless. Our mind is also something like that, restless. And if you give some wine to the monkey, then it becomes more restless. Is anyway by nature restless mind. And if you are giving food to the mind, then it will be more restless. So you have to learn how to make the mind fast. You have to know how to make the mind fast. That means I will not listen you, my dear mind. I will only listen Vaishnava. I will not listen you. I am going to only listen to the Vaishnava. That is the principle of making the mind disciplined. I will not listen. And that Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur used to say, morning and evening, you must kick the mind with the broom. With that song is there, Amara Jivana Sada Pape Rata. Govinda Maharaj also told. That's the order of Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur. Amara Jivana Sada Pape Rata. With that song, we have to kick morning and evening. Our mind, we may think we already become devotee, but that song reminds us where it is our real nature, real position. Are we making our mind fast, Madan Mohan Prabhu? or you are giving nice preparation to the mind.
Hare Krishna Maharaj.
Hare Krishna.
Yes, Maharaj, we are trying to control our mind by eating prasadam.
Eating prasadam.
By associating with devotees in terms of the current context, participating in sadhu sangha, getting weekly darshan of Gurudev, of Acharya Maharaj. Yes, Maharaj, and chanting. Not giving so much opportunity, Maharaj, for mind to think.
But Bhaktivinoda Thakur
says, very difficult, Maharaj.
But Bhaktivinoda Thakur says opposite. Yes, my mind is constantly engaged in wicked things. I have, engaged my mind in so many. Para dukhe, sukhi, sadha mithya vasi. Para sukha dukha kara. That is our mind's nature. Mind is getting so much of food, and that making the soul weak. That is making the soul weak. So mind has to be given strict discipline by not listening the mind at all. Not listening the mind at all and listening Guru and Vaishnava. Our senses may see something as rope because of the influence of the mind. But Guru is saying, no, that is snake. And we have to accept it. Yes, that is what a snake is. And then again Guru says, no, that is rope. Then we accept it as rope. And he changes so many times, then we have to accept it. Going beyond the influence of mundane senses, mind, it is very, very important thing. Uma Didi's connection is so weak, she is getting often dropped. So, very important thing here that, Krishna has told that one who has conquered the mind, how the Vaishnavas conquered their mind, what is the process they followed? What is the process they followed? Conquer their mind. They have some loving relationship with Guru and Vaishnava. That's why they are not listening to their mind. They are listening to what Guru and Vaishnava saying. What they are telling us. Thus, they have conquered the mind. So if you are following them, then our mind can also be disciplined. We will not follow our material mind. And thus, we can make their mind as our guide. And thus, that guiding mind is our friend. And this misguiding mind is our enemy. This material misguiding mind is our enemy. And the guidance that is coming from the mind of Guru and Vaishnava, that is our friend. So we have to know what is the friend and what is the enemy. That which is coming from me, that is enemy. That which is coming from above, that is my friend. Arjun could do that. Sarva dharman paritejya mam ekam saranam braja. That's complete surrender. And Arjun being asked by Krishna, and he followed that. And there is also something that Rishabdev told in Srimad Bhagavatam about this. I would like to share it with you. You all know that Rishabdev was one of the incarnation of Lord Hari, and there was a king called Arhat who imitated Rishabdev, and this Jain Dharma that came from there. Rishabdev has given one nice teaching here in Rishabdev's teaching. Nityam dadati kamasya chidram tam anu e aryaha योगिनः कृत मैत्रस्य पत्युर जाय जयेव पुंसली. An unchaste woman is very easily carried away by paramours, as it sometimes happens that her husband is violently killed by her paramours. If the yogi gives his mind a chance and does not restrain it, his mind will give facility to enemies like lust, anger, and greed, and they will doubtlessly kill the yogi. Purport. In this verse, the word Pumsali refers to a woman who is easily carried away by man. Such a woman is never to be trusted. Unfortunately, in the present age, women are never controlled. According to the directions of the Shastras, women are never to be given freedom. When a child, a woman must be strictly controlled by her father. When she is young, she must be strictly controlled by her husband. And when she is old, she must be controlled by her elderly sons. If she is given independence and allowed to mingle unrestrictedly with man, she will be spoiled. A spoiled woman being manipulated by paramours might even kill her husband. This example is given here because a yogi desiring to get free from material conditions must always keep his mind under control. Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur used to say that in the morning, our first business should be to beat the mind with shoes 100 times, and before going to bed, to beat the mind 100 times with a broomstick. In this way, one's mind can be kept under control. An uncontrolled mind and an unchaste wife are the same. An unchaste wife can kill her husband at any time, and an uncontrolled mind followed by lust, anger, greed, madness, envy, and illusion can certainly kill the yogi. When the yogi is controlled by the mind, he falls down into the material condition. One should be very careful of the mind, just as a husband should be careful of an unchaste wife. Such beautiful analogy is being given here. In the present time, people think everything is same. They want to make everybody same. That is not going to artificially happen. You cannot make everything same. There is certain abilities that women have, and there are certain defects that they have that cannot be eliminated actually. Now they want to change it by unnatural process, by operation and that, so many things they want to do. But can you operate and change somebody's mind, somebody's tendency? You can change the physical body, but how to operate and change somebody's mind? Is it possible? Yesterday, somebody asked in that meet, that's with scientists that we had. In that, somebody asked about cloning. Cloning can be done to copy the outward form, but you cannot clone the nature. I was telling that you can make a create a clone of Trump, but you cannot guarantee, or you cannot have a person looking like Trump also behaving like Trump. He may be having some other kind of behavior. You cannot clone the behavior. Like Kauravas, they are all clones, have same genetic material, and yet they are all different individuals, having different kind of nature, behavior, and all those things. Yes, Dr. Badal.
Maharaj, and at this present situation, modern feminist, modern women do accept your ideology, what you have expressed now.
I mean, that is what is Kali Yuga is all about. They want to have their artificially create equality. And then you see now what is happening in India. Often some problems are coming. Some badly people are behaving with women, and they are using, exploiting women by putting their very bad photos in advertisement. And you see, if the respect of women is going up by that.
Yes, I do believe. But the modern feminists, radical feminists.
Yes, that's what is Kali Yuga. That's what Kali Yuga is all about. I'm not saying Mandamati Mandabhagya. Their mind is wicked, and their fortune is also very bad. That's what is
person. It's very bad.
Because they don't want to listen. Fortune only come to the person who has Sukruti, who will listen from a higher direction. They don't have. They have to be, somehow fortune has to be created by giving them some Sukruti. And that's what Gaudiya Math is all about, creating some Sukruti. And they don't have any Sukruti, fallen soul. We are all fallen souls. But our acharyas, they are creating some scope for us by giving us some, you know, Sukruti, by engaging us in somewhere, knowingly or unknowingly, in some service towards the Absolute. So people can easily do some introspection. Either honor or respect for the ladies is going high. Of course, those persons who are also using scriptures in a wrong way to mistreat ladies, that is also not correct. And those who are not completely following scriptures and exploiting, that is also not correct. Both are not correct.
Yes.
Both are not correct, actually. Both are not correct. Women were highly respected in past. Mm-hmm. In the Vedic tradition, highly respected, actually. They were called a mother.
Mother.
Mother's position is such high.
But
now they have degraded so much and they're doing all kinds of bad kind of, you know, what you can say, attitude they have. Disrespectful attitude. And in the name of respect, they are doing all those things. And that is Kali Yuga. the mind is such a way degraded that you don't see your own falling down. You don't see that. And you feel that, my position is elevated. You feel like that. That is what is Kali Yuga is all about. Kali Yuga attacking our mind, not allowing it to have any intelligence. That's why mind is very important thing in the age of Kali, to be disciplined. If you give scope to the, if you give scope to the mind, then it can go to so many masters. It can have so many masters. It cannot become chaste. Mind supposed to serve your real self, to the soul, but it develops so many other masters: kama, krodha, lobha, moha, mada, master. Just so many other masters it develops in due course of time. Then difficult for such a mind to help us. Very nice explanation that being given by Rishabdev in that. And I want to also read something that Prahlad Maharaj told in this regard. Now from Srimad Bhagavatam 7.8.9. Jhayo asrum bhavam imam tvam atmanaha samam mano dhatsva na santi vid visaha rite ajitad atmana utpatte stitat tadhi hai anantasya mahat samar hanam. Prahlad Maharaj continued, my dear father, please give up your demoniac mentality. Do not discriminate in your heart between enemies and friends. Make your mind equipoised towards everyone. Expect for the uncontrolled and misguided. Except for the uncontrolled and misguided mind, there is no enemy within this world. When one sees everyone on the platform of equality, one then comes to the position of worshipping the Lord perfectly. Prahlad Maharaj is giving some suggestion to his father, very respectful way. His father wanted to harm him, but he is giving such lobbying kind of, you know, suggestion. He's telling, my dear father, please give up your demoniac mentality. So demon is not a person. We don't see Hiranyakashipu as only demon. Hiranyakashipu is there in our heart. That attitude, that behavior is there in our heart. The demons are in our heart. Ravan, Kumbhakarna, all those bad attitude. We don't just see outside, enemies and friend. Our enemy is our mind, material mind. Our friend is the transcendental mind. Those personalities who have transcendental mind, they are our friend. Then we will see everyone equally, because they are all souls. They are not some outward, you know, a reflection that you are seeing at present that they are in. They are not that actually. They are being infected by material consciousness. So our real enemy is our uncontrolled, misguided mind. So when one sees everyone on the platform of equality, one then comes to the position of worshipping the Lord perfectly. You cannot worship Lord by becoming envious, harsh towards other entities. You cannot worship. But they are all servants of the Absolute, all jivas by nature, the servant of the Absolute. By becoming envious and harsh towards others, you cannot properly worship. You are trying to eat the grain without offering it to Lord, then you are very much bad towards those grains. You may be enjoying, but grains are suffering. But when you offer those grains without onion, garlic, you cook it and offer it to Lord Krishna, then take that prasad, then that is good for the grain, because grain is being sacrificed for Lord's service. And when you take that prasad, then you will cultivate bhakti, love for the Lord. Holistic process. And by that process, those persons who watered that plant which produced those grains, those who carried those grains, all connected to that grains, they will get some sukruti, because that grain is being used in the service of the Lord. A holistic way, you can do benefit to whole society by becoming devotee. One devotee can do benefit to so many souls. If you become properly practicing this Krishna consciousness. Controlling your material mind. Don't listen to material mind and listen to the persons who have transcendental mind. Has to come to that type of, you know, platform. Don't listen to your enemy. Enemy will take you to very bad, you know, place. Indra was listening his enemy. His guru came. Then he was very busy by following his enemy mind, enjoying the dance of all these apsaras, the beautiful ladies of the heaven. Then he's telling to his guru that please tell him, wait some time, I'm a little busy. And then his guru wants to help him understand what is the result of following your enemy. Then he said, okay, you are very busy, then become pig. Then Indra become pig immediately. And started eating stool, have a pig wife and 100 piglets. And Indra become very happy with all this. That's what our position is. We supposed to have a very beautiful relationship with Lord. No lack of anything. So for his satisfaction, we will be doing everything. But at present, we are only searching for lower things. Now, Brahma could understand and try to help the Indra in the process. Like that, some Sadhu Guru Vaishnava may come and help us some by fortune, by the arrangement of Lord. And if we are fortunate enough to follow them, then we can also save ourselves from the enemy, our material mind, by accepting the guidance from our friend, that transcendental mind from Guru and Vaishnava. That's what I wanted to say for today's discussion. Is there any questions or comments anybody have? What we have discussed? All right. There is no questions. So let us do one kirtan on this. Very nice. You can all unmute your mic and follow. I sing first, then you can follow that. This is the Bhajo Hure Mano song by Srila Govinda Das Kaviraj. Bhajo Hure Mano Sri Nanda Nandana Abhaya Charanara Bindare.
Bhajahure mana Shri Nandana Abhaya Charanara Vinandare.
दुर्लभ मानव जन्म सत संगे तरहु ये भव सिंधु रे
दुर्लभ मानव जन्म सत संगे तरहु ये भव सिंधु रे
अभय चरण अरविंद रे भजहु
रे मनमानंद
सीत आतप बात बरीसन ए दिन जामिनी जागिरे
जागिरे
विफल से बिनु कृपण दुर्जन चपल सुख लभ लागिरे अभय चरण अरविंद रे
भजरे
न जौवन पुत्र परिजन इथे किया छे परती रे कमल दल जल जीवन टल मल भजहु हरि पद नीति रे
कमल दल जल जीवन टल मल भजहु हरि पद नीति रे
अभय चरण अरविंद रे
भजहु रे मनमानंद
अभय चरण अरविंद रे
श्रवण कीर्तन स्मरण वंदन पाद सेवन दास्य रे पूजन सखी जन आत्मनिवेदन गोविंद दास अभिलाष रे अभय चरण अरविंद रे
भजहु रे मनमानंद
अभय चरण अरविंद रे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे
हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे हरे
हरे
कृष्णा हरे कृष्णा हरे हरे
हरे राम 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 हरे हरे
Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama,
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna
Krishna, Nitai Gaurango, Nitai Gaurango, Jaya Nitai Gaurango. जय सच्चिदानंदन जय सच्चिदानंदन जय सच्चिदानंदन गौर हरि
जय सच्चिदानंद
जय सच्चिदानंद गौर हरि कलि युग पावन गौर हरि
पतित पावन गौर हरि
गौरा 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 गौर हरि जय गुरुदेव जय गुरुदेव गुरुदेव जय गुरुदेव
गुरुदेव
गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल नितय गौर हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल हरि बोल
नितय गौर
हरि बोल हरि
बोल
हरि बोल
नितय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि हरि बोल
हरि बोल
तो डॉक्टर राजेश त्यागी जी is it possible that you can read the translation
mind just worship the lotus feet of the son of nanda which make one fearless having obtained this rare human birth cross over the ocean of worldly existence through the association of saintly persons.
Govinda Das Kaviraj is saying a very nice thing to his mind. Just worship the lotus feet of son of Nanda, which makes one fearless. What is the meaning of lotus feet of son of Nanda? What is the meaning of that?
You mean like Vaishnav Guru?
Yes. Saying to mind, worship the lotus feet of son of Nanda, which makes one fearless. Abhay Charan De, Prabhupada's name, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami, Abhay Charan. So if you are following the transcendental mind, our friend, those who have transcendental mind, if you are following, then that is the proper, our friend, friendly mind. Then we got this rarely achieved human birth, 84 lakhs of species, but we got some rarely achieved human form of life. Then we should use it, vehicle, to cross over the material ocean by association with the saintly persons. Associating with them. What is the meaning of association? Eat with them with the same plate, sleep with them, that is association. Do you think that is the association? What is the meaning of association?
Association of.
Association means trying to keep their conception in your heart. Always think about what they need, what will make them happy, what I must do to make them happy. If you are always thinking like that, then you are associating with them. If you are only thinking how to make your mind happy, your body happy, then you are giving food to your mind. That is not association. You are staying in Vrindavan Dham, in Mathura Dham, in Puri Dham, in Navadvip Dham, but your mind is staying in London. Your mind is staying in South Africa, Malaysia, Nepal, in Mumbai, all these places. And then you are not staying there. You are actually staying in all other places, not in that Dham. But you may be staying in South Africa, London, Mumbai, Nepal, other places. But you are always thinking about the devotee, Vaishnava, how to please him. Then you are staying already in Vrindavan. You are already staying in Vrindavan. So that is the meaning of association with them. Always practice their conception in your life. Try to please them. Don't become a thief. Just take things from them. That will not work. You have to give. Tatvidhi pranipatena pariprasneno sevaya. Upadaksantite jnanam jnanina tatvadasana. Krishna will not be happy and not give you anything if you are not serving. Just taking. That is not going to help. That is not proper relationship. Proper relationship is you have to give. Give your money, give your mind, give your intelligence, give your strength. Give whatever you can give. By giving, you will not lose anything. You will gain. By keeping, you will go down. That is the principle. You have to learn to give. That is the most important thing. Then, the next translation. Can you read, Dr. Tyagiji?
Sir.
Yes.
Both in the day and at night, I remain sleepless, suffering the pains of the heat and cold, the wind and the rain, for a fraction of flicking happiness. I have uselessly served wicked and miserly men.
Wicked and miserly men. Both in day and night, I remain sleepless. I'm not getting any sleep because so many things, mind is searching for food. My enemy mind, material mind, is searching for the food. Then you are making it very strong. Then it is making you sleepless. Then you are suffering heat and cold, wind and the rain. Some kind of chapala sukha means the flickering, the sense happiness. That is flickering. I am serving wicked and miserly person for some kind of sense enjoyment. For enjoyment of tongue, for enjoyment of genital, for enjoyment of eye, for enjoyment of ear. We are serving so many people. Those who are having a wicked nature, miserly nature. Chapala sukha means sense enjoyment. That is not going to last. You eat some food, then again you will get desire for that food. You will not. That is not going to finish. Small happiness. That's not lasting one. That is my position. Because of following wicked mind, my enemy. Let me see. Dr. Badal, is it possible that you read the third one?
Yes, Swamiji, yes, Maharaji. Yes. What assurance of real happiness is there in all of one's wealth, youthfulness, sons, and family members? This life is tottering like a drop of water on the lotus petal. Therefore, you should always serve and worship the divine feet of Lord Hari.
We are searching for some happiness in all temporary things. Krishna already told, samsara dukkhalayam asaswatam. Sansar means endless cycle of birth and death. that is the place of misery and temporary. That you know, wealth, that youth, sons and family that you are thinking too much proud of, they are going to die and you are going to die. They go somewhere, you go somewhere. And you are searching happiness with their association. They are anyway going to separate from you. That is assured. It is assured, actually, guaranteed. But you are not seeing that because our life is something like the drop of water on the lotus, this, you know, petal. It any time may fall down, go. Then why not be using it for serving under the direction of Vaishnav, devotees of the Lord? That is the question that we should ask the mind. Mind, why are you so much naughty? I'm not going to listen to you. I will listen to Sadhu, Guru, Vaishnav. What they say, I will follow that. I will not going to listen to you. Can you read the next one?
Okay. It is the desire and great longing of Govinda Das to engage himself in the nine processes of bhakti, namely hearing the glories of Lord Hari and chanting those glories constantly, remembering him and offering prayers to him, serving the Lord's lotus feet, serving the Supreme Lord as a servant, worshipping him with the flowers and incense and so forth, serving him as a friend and completely offering the Lord one's very self.
Such beautiful Govinda Das prayer. Navavida Bhakti, try to practice that under the direction of a Vaishnav. That should be your desire. You should not have any other desires for satisfying your senses. Wicked mind, enemy mind, mundane intelligence, false ego. No, we have to hanker for serve the Lord under the guidance of Vaishnav, Guru and Vaishnav. Such beautiful song that Govinda Das compiled. Good thing that our mind should be engaged in that. I thank you all for your participation. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Because of your all association, we could remember something that our gurus taught us. I thank you, all of you, for that. Vancha kalpataru vasya kipa sindhu bhaya vacha patitanam pavane bhyo vaishna bhyo namo namaha. Jai saparikasi si guru gauranga gandharva govinda sundar jiu ki jai. Jai vishnupad paramansa paribraja kacha jagat guru sila bhakshya damadar gursai maharaj ki jai. Jai vishnupad paramansa paribraja kacha jagat guru sila bhakti madhav puri maharaj ki jai. Jai vishnupad paramansa paribraja kacha jagat guru sila bhakti nirmal acharya gursai maharaj ki jai. Jai vishnupad paramansa paribraja kacha jagat guru sila bhakti sundar govinda dev gursai maharaj ki jai. Jai vishnupad paramansa paribraja kacha jagat guru sila esi bhakti se prabhupada ji maharaj ki jai. Jai vishnupad paramansa paribraja kacha jagat guru sila bhakti rakshasya dev gursai maharaj ki jai. भगवान श्रील भक्ति सिद्धांत सष्टक प्रभुपा जी महाराज की जय. महाभागवत श्रील गौर किशोरदास बाबा जी महाराज की जय. सच्चिदानंद भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर की जय. वैष्णव सर्वम जगन्दास बाबा जी महाराज की जय. बलदेव विद्याभूषण प्रभु की जय. नरोत्तम दास ठाकुर की जय. कृष्णदास कविराज गोस्वामी महाराज की जय. वृंदावन दास ठाकुर महाशय की जय. रूपानुग गुरुवर्ग की जय. नमाचार्य हरिदास ठाकुर की जय. प्रेम से बोला श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सादि गौर भक्तविंद की जय. स्वरूपानंद रामदादी भक्तविंद की जय. मुरारी गुप्त प्रभु की जय. सपार्षद नित्यानंद प्रभु की जय. सपार्षद महाप्रभु की जय. भक्ति देवी वृंदा देवी की जय. गंगा देवी जमुना देवी की जय. ग्रंथराज श्रीमद भागवतम की जय. चैतन्य 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 भागवत की जय. भक्तराज प्रहलाद महाराज की जय. शुद्ध भक्ति विग्रह विनाशन भगवान नरसिंहदेव की जय. जय श्री जगन्नाथ बलदेव सुभद्र सुदर्शन जीव की जय. जगन्नाथ पुरी धाम की जय. मायापुर नवदीप धाम की जय. अपराध भंजन पारसी कौलदीप की जय. जय श्री गुप्त गोवर्धन की जय. जय श्री सदाशिव गंगाधर जीव की जय. जय श्री मथुरा वृंदावन धाम की जय. जय श्री श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड गिरी गोवर्धन की जय. जय श्री चैतन्य सरस्वत मठ की जय. तदे विश्वव्यापी सकसम की जय. तदे विश्वव्यापी सेवक वृंद भक्त वृंद की जय. श्री चैतन्य सरस्वत इंस्टीट्यूट की जय. प्रिंसटन भक्ति वेदांत इंस्टीट्यूट की जय. समवेत भक्त वृंद की जय. जय श्री पाद कृष्ण किंकर प्रभु की जय. कनुप्रिया दीदी की जय. मदन मोहन प्रभु की जय. गोविंद प्रभु की जय. डॉक्टर राजेश जी की जय. समवेत भक्त वृंद की जय. हरिनाम संकीर्तन की जय. निताय गौर प्रेमानंदे हरि बोल. थैंक यू वेरी मच
ऑल ऑफ यू. भक्ति निष्काम शांता महाराज की जय.
जय
जय.
Joy. I think all of you have the Sangha details of Srila Acharya Maharaj. So we will meet there shortly. Dandavat Pranam.